Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Novaspirit Tech, and recently this topic's been popping up on my newsfeed a lot, which is installing Android Auto on our Raspberry Pi. So I decided to investigate to see how intuitive or how easy it is to install it, which leads us to this video, so let's get started. Now to begin, we are going to need a Raspberry Pi 3 and some sort of touchscreen. So yeah, I am using a 5-inch touchscreen which you can buy from Amazon. I'll leave a link in the description below. This does use the GPIO pins for the touchscreen, and as you can see, it does work. And it is hooked up to my phone right now as Android Auto. Now you could also get, if you're planning to put this in your car, one of these little devices. Now this one I bought back in 2007 when I was doing my first car PC. And if you guys know anything or OGs about the car PCs, you know about these screens, the Lily pudding screens now. But yes, this is a 8-inch screen for double DIN, and it has mounting holes for the radio slots, and basically it works right out of the bat. It does have multiple inputs, so if you have reverse cameras and stuff like that, it will work with this guy as well. Now, the installation process itself is a little bit tedious. I followed the guy's instructions and everything. It's not hard, but it's just a lot of commands that you gotta go through. So instead of doing that, I actually wrote a script that you can find on my GitHub, links in the description below, and everything else that we're talking about. This script will actually automatically install all the dependencies, all the software, and everything you need to get Android Auto working, along with installing an auto start script, which as soon as you boot up the device, it'll boot right into Android Auto. Now, obviously, we're going to be using the latest version of Stretch with the desktop version. And when you're done installing that using Etcher, we're going to hop into our Raspberry Pi. All right, so here we're at our desktop. Just imagine everything's pre-done, which is connecting to Wi-Fi and keyboard settings and all that. The first thing we need to do is download my Git, which is the script that we're going to be using to install Android Auto. So git clone https github.com/novaspirit, if I could spell correctly, Novaspirit Android Auto RPI_install. Okay, once that's done, we'll list it, change directory over to Android Auto. Now I'm gonna chmod, which is gonna turn into an executable, install.sh. Once that's done, we just do /install.sh. And now it's gonna run all the repositories and install everything you need to do and do everything. And once at the end of this, it will automatically boot into Android Auto. And if you reboot the system, it will also automatically reboot into Android Auto. So this will take about 20 minutes to half an hour. So go grab a drink and we'll be right back. Alright, so as you can see, everything does work. It is hooked up to my Android phone. Navigation does work, also the traffic information, and it's not too bad as far as speed wise goes. If you want to check out the music app, you could use Google Play Music or whatever you want. You could also install other apps into it, like Waze and stuff, just to get this going. But I'm not going to talk more about the Android app. I'm more so just showing you guys how easy it is, or how nice it actually moves. Well, I'll leave a link to another image that you guys could get called Crankshaft. Now this guy's been actually developing this project as an actual image that you could load into the SD card. The only problem I found with that was it's got a limited understanding of what displays you can use, so that's why I went the route of doing it yourself. Now his image supports the official Raspberry Pi display, while mine I could just use whatever I want, and that's why I decided to show you this. But yeah, again, I will leave all the links in the description to the crankshaft and to the build that I'm using. Everything you could play around with is going to be in the descriptions below. So now that you have everything installed, which is awesome, the only key feature that is missing and doesn't work right now is Bluetooth, which isn't a deal breaker for me because I'm really just using this for navigation and Waze. Yeah, I mean, it's great. So I've been playing around with this guy for the past couple of days, and it's very smooth. I don't have any issues with load times or the map struggling or anything like that. It's been really good on this Raspberry Pi. The graphics seems to be working pretty smoothly. Not anything that would bother me. Now for me, I'm gonna be keeping an eye on this project myself because I actually like where this is headed. Remember, this is still in its infancy of this software where a lot of stuff is still being implemented. So keep your eyes peeled on the software as well. So, well, that's it for me. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. If you guys have any questions about this, hit them in the comments below. I'll try to answer as much as I can. If you guys got any ideas for a next car computer project, hit up in the comments below. I wanna see if it's something I could attempt. If you guys are new to the channel, consider subscribing and also hitting that little bell notification icon so you know when the next video is gonna be out. And as I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.